up airs alone. Snake being, you know, a big boy, like he can take a lot of damage off that up air, and especially when he likes the PS2 with the platforms there, it's going to allow him to be able to carry him over and over the second he like finds his way through the opening. And he also can play the projectile game. He's got fireballs of his own. And Sauce, you know, recently beating Dill and Ralphie to get up to this point. Let's see how he does against the likes of Pelka.
Yes, already off to a quick start, like I said, using that short hop down air as an approaching tool. Yeah, again, just really good at setting up into whatever vertical combos Mario has to work with. And because Snake is such a heavy character, Ozzy, like you said, he's going to be very susceptible to these low percent combos. He's probably not going to be dying to much of them, but any damage is good damage in a matchup like this. As you can see, neutral is pretty much just, this is war trench.
Yeah.
You're
going to see this a lot, right? Especially because they're both from New England. You know, number 6 from Pelka fighting against number 13 from Sauce would be an upset if Sauce got the victory. So all stats are saying Pelka should win this, but those are just numbers, man. We're playing with emotions. I like that trade exchange right there, center stage. You saw all the things happening. Sauce is actually trying to hold on to that grab. What? Sent Snake flying like a rocket. What in the world? Woo! No, man, you gotta look out for that Super Mario Sunshine. He's dropping down. I saw that coming. God. He actually registered the Nikita missile from the top of the stage and let it drop like a rock to try to catch Sauce off guard. This is when you're fighting against the likes of Snake. You need those headphones, which is why Sauce is wearing them. You need to hear those sound effects.
Oh, yeah.
Sound is so important.
Playing against Snake without sound is impossible. There we go.
Nice call
up
out.
Smash finds its mark.
And
you're going to roll.
You're going to see that a lot from Sauce, right? Going for the up smash to try to cover these ledge options, because not only is it destructive, it's also pretty safe. There's very little cooldown afterwards. Pelka had to go for that air dodge in. Honestly, remember Pelka's off. What a trade. What a trade.
I wish I could extend my leg up that high.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
I mean,
oh, mama!
I mean, if you're going to land down right in front of him, man, that's one of the things that Sauce loves to go for, forward smash.
Oh,
it's going to be
goodness.
A two-stock to one-stock lead for Sauce. So you try to carry this around. He wants the grab. I like that exchange.
Oh my god!
Where are you going? Where are you going?
Mamma mia!
Papa Pia. Okay, you got that. You saw him. He was holding onto that grenade and set him up so... Pelka is so good. I gain these conversions off of grenades. What is going on here?
I was just playing a 30-19.
Why
man.
Was Sauce not holding shield? I was so confused. The grenade was sitting there. Maybe he was trying to parry it? But then he wasn't holding shield, so I don't know. Okay, fireball, back air. Good
nice tech
from Pelka. He had to get that tech in order to get back on the stage. But he is setting up for something, but Sauce doesn't care. Catches the landing with a fall. Gets the up smash. Gets the kill. It's going to be Sauce taking away game number one from Pelka. And what
so
we thought
smart,
was going to be kind of a slow-moving game, it all of a sudden became extremely explosive.
Yeah, it was for a little bit. I think there was just kind of both guys getting a feel of what to do against each other. As you see Sauce again trying to get, you know, we're taking a look back at the first set and... Snake's up tilt.
What? I love that replay, dude. That's my favorite. That's my favorite replay in the game.
I want that on repeat for the rest of my life.
And here comes my favorite kill. This is my kill of the day. Right, if you had to ask Austin for his kill of the day, this is the one.
There you go. Once again, gets the jab because he's holding a grenade.
You double jumping where you going. Because that entire setup was because of he hit him with the singular jab, waited for Sauce to swing at him, but because Sauce swung, pushed the A button rather, he picked up the grenade instead, and Pelka could capitalize off that because he was holding onto the grenade. He timed the back throw so that he couldn't like get it out of his hands in time, so he could set up to the top with the explosion and set him up for disaster with that forward air.
Yeah,
let's go back into game number two again. Even though Pelka had that play of the game, Sauce is still the one that got the W. You know,
so that means it doesn't really happen. But did it really happen if you got?
It's like, you know, the opponent's team won, but your Reinhardt got play of the game still, so it was like, who cares? Like, you can brag.
At the end of the day, I'm the best. It's going on YouTube.
So let's go into game number two. Here we go. Okay, forward tilt. He was hoping that he was going to roll to the left. You saw him holding there, standing still patiently.
And again, just opting for the same approach from before. These aerial fireballs. Buying him a little bit of coverage. That could have been really pesky for both players right there.
You see how close Sauce got to that C4? He was narrowly out of range from that explosion. Waits for him to like trigger it before he's trying to dash in a little bit more. If at first they don't succeed, try again.
Yeah, man. You know how much stretching you must do to be able to do that so quickly? Like, that's hard. And there we go. Once again, 69% on the docket right now.
He does a hell of yoga.
Yeah, you're right.
Forward tilt. Tries, you know, punishing that whiffed grab.
This is exactly what I meant, Aussie, by the lead. You can just get away from you sometimes against Snake. If you're not paying attention, you start getting the tunnel vision of, okay, I need to break zone. I need to get myself back in the game. And then stuff like that happens. You're now 3-1 in game two.
What a trap. Sauce. If you're... Whatever, man. Just throw it out. Just head bonk him. Toss him in the air. Okay, back. Okay, honestly, at this point, Pelka's going for the trades. He's constantly trying to just spawn grenades. Even if he gets hit in the process, Sauce is taking damage. That's going to benefit him in the long run because he's the one that has more stocks currently.
Yeah, man, without a doubt.
He spawns a grenade off again, catches him swinging, connects the grab.
I love that Sauce is kind of like hard-bodying these grenades and just running through them whenever Pelka like throws them.
I like how Sauce used that grenade like Snake, right? Sauce found himself with the grenade, so he's holding shield while holding onto it, so the explosion would hit Pelka, but catches yet another up smash. He's not out of the woods just yet, man. Like, he could bring this back to a 2-0.
This is definitely very doable for Sauce if he plays his cards right.
Yeah, now C4 right there where Sauce was, which is why he rolled out of there. He recognized the explosion. I mean, that's the benefit of PS2 with Snake. Those platforms are perfectly placed where if there's a C4 on top of it, the opponent from below can get caught. Okay, more fireball spammage coming out, looking for this opening. He waits for him to commit to an option. That it was the jump, but the grenade came out because he dropped it, and he caught it with a back air.
Ooh.
Sour spot of Nair sets up very beautifully for the combo.
Oh my god, he jumped into that. That's why he got hit. Now Pelka has to be very careful. That could have been really bad, but rolls out of disadvantage.
Oh, stuck between a rock and a hard place here with these explosions. Comes back, falling down with the neutral air. Trying to find his way back down. Gets the down throw. Sets him up for the forward tilt. If you're not going to move, I'm going to move you for you, son. That's going to be Pelka taking game number two, 1-1.
Yeah, man. But Sauce, mounting that comeback very, very nicely. That could have been really, really bad for Pelka. And again, the entire complexion of the set could have been turned on its head right there because it is so different going into game three, down 2-0. Than
I like this
1-1.
Stock right here. Because what happened here, if you can replay that again, Devin, he throws out the fireball, right? He shoots off the Nikita missile to force him to approach. But because he was doing it, all those explosions were coming into the center and it caught him off guard. But then Sauce, you know, recovering with great compose, you know, he just goes for the up smash after catching that roll. And that's going to be it for Sauce going into this game number three. Let's see if he's got a counter pick going up to bat in this next game in the set, man. I mean, honestly, no one really thought this set was going to be this close, but Pelka is actually being, you know, put into a corner a bit by Sauce. Sauce putting on a big show for us today.
Ooh, my man going for the in-between set fist bump.
Yeah.
Yikes.
Is that awkward?
It's a little awkward.
I don't like it, man.
Especially in a 5-game set, you got to touch fists with the guy 5 times.
You don't see that too often in top 8 either.
As you can tell, this is... Sorry, I'm not usually from these parts.
Okay, you're going stubbing into Unova. This is a different type of parts you got to go through. Now, this is interesting, right? Because this is Sauce's counter pick. It's very similar to PS2, just a slightly smaller. Those platforms, you know, could benefit Mario a little bit more than Snake. We'll just have to wait and see. Yeah, the grenade. You saw him immediately try to go for the Z-drop the second he was thrown because he did not want that grenade in his hand.
Yeah, man. You see right away, you know.
Up airs.
Oh!
Good. Now you see him go for the giant punch off of the up airs. That's exactly what he gets off of those platforms. Because they're closer to the ledge than PS2, it allows him to set up combos just like that on the stage. Where are you going? I mean, that's the quickest option you could have gone for, so I respect it.
Yeah,
that spacing!
Really nice stuff here from Sauce in the early presents here. Pelka again on the back foot. You can't pull grenades if you can't pull anything.
Where is this momentum coming from?
Whatever is in Sauce to Sauce right now, it is working.
Catches the down tilt.
Oh my god!
That was fantastic DI from Pelka. He runs in there, gets the up tilt, sends him flying. The thing is, Sauce actually pushed him offstage with that down tilt, trying to connect that into a down smash, but because Pelka was DI'ing away, the confirm did not happen. Goes for the back throw, push him offstage, forgot that the C4 was in place. Potential edge guard, waits to go for the ledge option instead.
Goes for the back throw, gets Pelka just trying to set up shop right now, but Sauce finding good routes to get around these grenades. Back air is going to force Pelka's hand to recover high once again, but no, opts to recover low instead.
Ledge attack just to get Mario off of him, sitting at 170%. This is starting to become difficult. Pelka has some momentum here, gets the up tilt. They're both in the air.
Oh,
they didn't want to switch. You saw Sauce goes for the down air, gets the kill. Sauce finds himself with yet another lead. He's got to be careful. It looks like he's trying to bail out the up tilts, but the second invincibility wore off, managed to connect that grab. My man is just spamming
there.
Words. Down B.
Back up air.
Yeah. Back air? There it is.
There you go. So even up at one stock of beats once again. Jesus Christ, Pelka.
I've seen Pelka do that before. I don't want to see it happen again. Thankfully, Sauce is still in that spawn platform, so there was no capitalization from Sauce on that.
Okay, reads the air dodge. Continuing the combo tree, but that grenade going to buy Pelka at least a little bit more time.
I like that down air placement was above the grenade, so it didn't trigger the explosion.
Jeez, man.
Causes him to just do these backflips over, try to space out these back airs. He just can't get away from these grenades. Down tilt.
Ooh, jeez.
There we go.
They're using a neutral air to release. Add on some damage. Good trade right there for Pelka.
You see Pelka constantly going for these neutral airs, right? He gets a lot of massive damage off of those.
Oh my goodness.
Muscle's a forward air spike. He's done for it. Oh, he gets the tech. Hold on a sec.
Oh, the trade, and there we go. Sauce going up 2-1 on Pelka.
So that was Sauce putting in work. Honestly, people always talk about how Pokemon Stadium 2 and Unova are so similar layouts, right? Because they're both dual platforms, right? But we saw how drastic the difference was based on this stage compared to the last one. When Snake puts those C4s on those platforms, they don't really reach Mario from that low on the ground.
Yeah, the platform heights definitely are the biggest difference you can find here on this stage.
And in that first combo as well, when he got the down throw into the forward air off of the up air, like when it was that close to the stage, that could only happen on Unova. Yes, that is the character that just won that previous game. Okay, back air. Coming back into it. This is the moment, right? He goes for the back air offstage, gets the tech, but he was put in a really bad spot, so gave him a free back air trade. They both connected back air, so we had a misinput with the stages.
Yeah, wrong character, by the way.
Yeah, I was going to say Dark Pit.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yo, what you know about the Pelka Dark Pit, because I know nothing.
Well... Got the spike, man. And honestly, you know, this is like Sauce's character, right? People actually love seeing him this far in the bracket. There's a lot of people in the audience cheering for him, and he's all smiles.
He's a local guy.
He's grinning from ear to ear.
What gave it away that he's from Philadelphia? Would it be the Eagles jersey or the Eagles hat?
What? Nah, what?
Yeah, what are you talking about?
You're right.
Alrighty, so. What are you looking at here? Yep, it's going to be Snake versus Mario for Game 4. Pelka, once again, trying to send it to Game 5. Sauce trying to punch himself with a ticket to either have a date with Ling Ling or Dill. So,
honestly, I mean, it's all about choosing the correct person, you know, to share that special date with. Here we go. Town and City, 3 stocks apiece. Like I said, Sauce is super close to this. Next is up airs. There we go. More explosions coming out hot.
Ooh, caught the grenade. Off the Heezy. Oh my god! That was crazy! He comboed Pelka's own grenade explosion into another up air.
I love Pelka, man.
Jeez, man.
Okay, goes off top of it again. I like the B reverse off that grenade. He just threw it out. Philadelphia's up roaring for their boy.
Again, you see Sauce starting to get comfortable now with the set play. Mm-hmm. You see him starting to use Pelka's own grenades in his own combos.
Yeah. Nikita missile coming in. He can manage to nick it with the fireball. The combos begin. Ooh. Takes the purple coins.
What's up, Cappy?
How you doing, bro? I mean, he's trying to get the 100%.
I'm saying.
The explosions. Still going to live. Fantastic DI coming from Sauce. He challenged it.
Oh, no. Not again.
Oh! What a throwaway, Sauce. What a throwaway. He capitalizing on that mistake from Pelka. Goes off super deep. Throws away his own stock to connect that forwarder and gets another kill.
Ground control to Major Tom. We have the makings of a major upset here as the Philly crowd has come alive for their boy. And Pelka, his bell's definitely rung right now. I don't think you can see he's, again, just trying to set up shop once again. Throw these grenades, maybe buy himself some breathing time.
There we go. Nice dash attack, pushes him out of harm's reach. You know, it's a very good cross-up for Snake. Tries to go for the confirm, but the back air from Mario seems to be faster. Up tilt, not gonna find its mark. Does it a second time, might be the stale
of this third one.
He won it, he was looking for it. He turned around to get it.
Snake!
He's living, 111% on Pelka. He's responding to the calls. Crowds over. Okay. Gets the up tilt. That's all he needed. Now this is Pelka's time to shine. He has to do something.
Oh my goodness.
Gets the parry on the neutral air. Very easy parry when it's a long-lasting move like that.
Goes for the empty hop forward smash.
That was supposed to be a forward tilt. Look out. Sauce is looking to try to get that back here.
You see Sauce just swinging right now. That's definitely the size of someone that's feeling the nerves.
Well, he wants the nair. If he gets that nair, it might be over. Okay, air dodges to get back on the stage. Sauce just respecting it.
He just did it.
He's walking away. He's off to his boys.
There you go, man.
My man is hugging. The crowd is loving him. Look at that. They are pumping him up. What a win for him. Taking out Pelka from New England at fifth place finish.
Wow, man. That was absolutely insane.
No one expected this. No one expected Sauce to get this far.
Look at that. That's what changed the complexion. Taking advantage of that low recovery, even if it meant throwing away the stock and making things maybe a little bit closer to the vest.
This
forward. Like at the end.
And Pelka just put himself in what happened. I wonder if he buffed that air dodge. But
good
boom!
Go!
You're gone. I'm taking you with me. Good night.
That was so good, man. Oh, man. And here we go. You see Pelka?
Literally.
Yeah, he was trying.
Can we talk about that last stock for a second? Because he threw that headset. He was like, I'm out of here. Let's go. See you later.
Why does everything?
New England never heard of you. My man was walking.
Why does everything look so much funnier in slow motion? That's what I can.
Pelka. Pelka was just like, look at that one more time. Just look at Pelka's face as he puts out the hand for the handshake. He was like, good games. He's like, I'm not having any of that. It wasn't a good game. That was an awful game. Why didn't you play better against me?
Oh my god. That's so
Let's go, Sauce. My god.
Let's go, Sauce.
I love Pelka, but man, I'm I'm mixed, right? Because I'm sad that Pelka's out at fifth place.
Yeah.
But Sauce, this is so crazy to see him get.
It's a great.